Triarch Praetorians are the ancient guardians of the Necron race who watched over them during their long sleep. And in this video, we're going to show you how to paint one of these miniatures in the colours of the Sautekh Dynasty. We're going to be using the classic method and we'll paint the model up to battle ready as well. And as with any set of miniature, the first thing you need to do is to undercoat your models. And for these ones, we recommend using lead belcher spray, which you can see is what I've sprayed my miniature with just here. Now you can instead paint the lead belcher on by hand if you prefer. And if you choose to do so, we recommend you spray your model with Chaos Black first of all. But either way, once your model is completely silver, you're ready to start base coating your details on there. And the first colour we need is Retributor Armour. Now this I'm going to be applying using a medium base brush, and what you should do is get some of this paint and put it onto a palette like this, because in doing so you can then thin your paint down with a little bit of water. Don't need very much, but just a small amount thinned in and mixed in there like that. This will just make the paint a lot smoother. It'll go further, it'll dry smoother, and it'll give you more control over it too. So once you've done that, all you need to do is start applying this to all the details that we want to be gold. And on this miniature, the real middle of him is all gold. So we're talking about the shoulder pads here, going down over the chest around this rib cage and going all the way around the back as well. Now he does have this design going across his back with this kind of raised up spine here, and it can be a little bit tricky getting underneath here because, well, it's the shoulder plates beneath that are gold. But you can always paint in between these ridges here. If you do happen to catch any of them with the gold paint, don't worry about it, just neat that up with the lead belcher before you continue. Now also there's a little bit of gold on the Rod of Covenant. We need to paint the bottom part just around here and also the collar up here as well. Once you finish base coating all the gold, you can then move on to base coating the remaining base colours that we need to apply to the miniature. And first of all, we're going to be using Corvus Black, which will be for all the black details, such as the cables. And then we're going to move on to Corax White for all the details we want to be white, such as the faceplate, but also any of the bright green as well, like the orbs. After that, we need Caliban Green, and so for the darker green, such as the top and bottom of the Rod of Covenant. But first of all, we need Corvus Black, which I'm again going to be applying with my medium base brush. But for this step, you might have a medium layer brush in hand as well for a bit more finer detail for when you get to smaller details that you want to paint black. But throughout this, once again, you need to use your palette, adding a touch of water to your paint so it's nice and smooth. There we go, get a little bit more paint there. There we are. And once you've done so, all you need to do is start picking out all the black details. So as I said earlier, we need to take a look at some cables. For example, these ones just under the chest right here. But also at this stage, you need to make sure that you base coat all of the ank as well. Now on the Rod of Covenant, we need to paint the main body of it, so the grip going all the way down here and around the hand. There we are, like that. And also these ridges that run along here too. The next colour to apply is Corax White, applied with a medium layer brush. And this is first of all for the white details, such as the faceplate being really neat around here, but also for any details that later we want to be bright green, for example the orbs, of which are scattered all around the miniature, for example this one around here. Also be sure to look out for any other bright details, such as cables, and also the raised part of the ank on the front here, in which case just very lightly apply a brush like this just to pick out that raised texture. And finally, base coat the designs on the top and bottom of the Rod of Covenant using Caliban Green. Now that we've finished applying all the base paints to the miniature, we can move on to the next phase, which is to apply the shade paints to it. And for this, we're going to be using three different colours. First of all, we need Norn Oil, and then we're going to be moving on to Agrax Earthshade, and then finally, we need a small amount of Hexwraith Flame. But first of all, we need Norn Oil, and I'm mostly going to be applying this with a medium shade brush, but it's a good idea to have a medium layer brush on hand for this colour, because, well, you'll see why in a moment. But what we're aiming to do here, first of all, is to build up a puddle of this paint on your palette like this, because we can then draw the paint from the palette. And this way we can make sure the brush isn't overloaded. Because rather than painting this all over the miniature, we only want it on certain select colours. So the areas I'm going to be applying it to, first of all, are all the silver details, so you can see the lower part of the body down here. But we also want to be painting onto the black details, such as the cables around here. We also need to paint it onto the dark green, such as the blades around here, and we also want to paint it onto the faceplate over the white detail around there, whilst avoiding the little orb on the forehead. That's what the medium layer brush is for, so you can get a little bit more control around that area. But all you need to do is paint the shade over these colours like this, then give the miniature around about half an hour to dry. Next, we're ready to apply Agrax Earthshade over all of the gold details, and because we only want to paint the gold details here, we recommend using a medium layer brush for this stage. And finally, paint all the bright green details using Hexwraith Flame applied with your medium layer brush. Once you've finished applying the shade to the miniature, you're then ready to move on to the final phase, which is to add some texture to the base. And for this, we're going to be using Sterling Mud. Now, to apply this kind of paint, what you need is one of these texture tools, and to use it, just using the shovel side, get a good scoop of the paint like this, And then just look for an open spot on the base of your miniature. So around the front is a good idea. All you do is put the paint onto it like that, and then use the tool to start moving the texture paint around the base, going right up to the feet of the miniature. When you do get close to the feet, you can switch around to the narrower side for a little bit more control. But once you've finished applying this all to the top of the base, give the miniature around about an hour to dry, then all you need to do is to paint the rim of the base. And for this miniature, I'm going to use Steel Legion Drap. And with that texture paint now completely dry and the rim of the base now painted, this Triarch Praetorian is now battle ready. So when you're painting these miniatures like this, there's a few key things to remember. The first is that you should always make sure you use an appropriately sized brush for the kind of area that you're painting. Also, when you're applying shade to the miniature, be careful not to put on too much at once so that you don't lose control of it and get it onto details where you don't want it. But really, that's all you need to know, so we hope you have fun painting your models, and we'll see you all again very soon.